Hello friends, welcome to this video on number system. In our previous video, we studied about rational and irrational numbers and learned to identify them. But still, there are times when we get confused and end up making mistakes. In this session, we will discuss some facts related to rational and irrational numbers. Let's start with the first question. If rational numbers are the ratio of integers, is 1 by 0 also a rational number? Friends, if we look at the definition of rational number, it says that the rational number is in the form p by q, where both p and q are integers and q is not 0. But why do we say that? 1 by 0 or any integer by 0 means that dividing that number by 0. Can you divide any number by 0? That is, the division of any number by 0 is impossible. Therefore, in P by Q, where Q is 0, it is called an undefined number. 1 by 0 is not a rational number. Rather, it is undefined. Let us see the next fact. In our previous classes, we have solved many questions related to the circumference or area of the circle. The formula for circumference and area of a circle is 2 pi r and pi r square respectively, and where pi is sometimes given as 22 by 7 or sometimes 3.14. The value of pi is 3.14159265 etc., in which the digits after the decimal are not repeated or nor do they end. Or you can say pi is an irrational number while 22 by 7 is a rational number. The decimal form of 22 by 7 is 3.14285714857. However, it is used after two decimal places, that is 3.14. This method is used for approximations but not for an exact answer. This does not mean the value of pi is 22 by 7. Pi is an irrational number and 22 by 7 is a rational number. Just as we can represent natural number 5 as a rational number by writing 5 by 1, can we also write root 2 as root 2 by 1 and say that it is a rational number? You can also pause the video to think about it. According to the definition of rational number, both p and q must be integers. Q, which we have taken as 1, is an integer, but root 2 is not an integer. So, we cannot represent it as a rational number. Friends, that's all in today's session. In this session, we discuss some facts related to rational and irrational numbers. See you in the next video. Thank you.